हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडेज टॉपिक इज आइस प्लांट एंड कूलिंग टावर। दिस इज द वर्किंग साइकिल ऑफ आइस प्लांट। हेयर द बेसिक कंपोनेंट ऑफ आइस प्लांट वी कैन से हेयर दिस इज द आइस कैन, दिस इज चिलिंग टैंक, ब्राइन, दिस इज द सेकेंडरी रेफ्रिजरेंट, हेयर इवोपरेटर, कंप्रेसर, कंडेंसर, रिजर्वायर, थ्रॉटल वाल्व एंड हेयर इज द कूलिंग टावर। दीज आर द बेसिक कॉम्पोनेंट विच आर यूज इन प्रोडक्शन ऑफ आइस। नाउ वी विल डिस्कस द अबाउट द वर्किंग ऑफ द साइकिल। हेयर दिस इज द फर्स्ट साइकिल विच इज कम्प्लीटेड थ्रू द कंप्रेसर, कंडेंसर, रिजर्वायर, थ्रॉटल वाल्व एंड इवोपरेटर। दिस साइकिल इज नोन एज द वेपर कंप्रेशन रेफ्रिजरेशन साइकिल। हेयर दिस साइकिल इज नोन एज द प्राइमरी साइकिल। इन दिस वी आर यूजिंग द प्राइमरी रेफ्रिजरेंट। द पर्पज ऑफ द प्राइमरी साइकिल टू एब्जॉर्ब द हीट बाई द प्राइमरी रेफ्रिजरेंट इन टू द इवोपरेटर फ्रॉम द ब्राइन सोल्यूशन। हेयर दिस रेफ्रिजरेंट इज सेंट टू द कंप्रेसर विच कंप्रेसेस रेफ्रिजरेंट फ्रॉम लो प्रेशर टू हाई प्रेशर एंड सेंट टू द कंडेंसर। हेयर एक्शन टेक्स प्लेस एंड इन केस ऑफ आइस प्लांट द कंडेंसर इज यूज्ड वाटर कूल्ड कंडेंसर बिकॉज द अमाउंट ऑफ हीट एक्सट्रैक्शन इज नीडेड मोर। इट मीन्स द कैपेसिटी ऑफ कंडेंसर इज नीडेड मोर इन केस ऑफ आइस प्रोडक्शन। सो दिस इज मेड वाटर कूल्ड कंडेंसर। हेयर द कूलिंग मीडियम विल इंटर फ्रॉम द कूलिंग टावर इन टू द कंडेंसर। आफ्टर एब्जॉर्बिंग द हीट दिस वाटर इज सेंट टू द कूलिंग टावर। सो हेयर कूलिंग वाटर इज ट्रांसफर टेक्स प्लेस थ्रू द कूलिंग टावर एंड कंडेंसर। फ्रॉम द कंडेंसर एब्जॉर्ब द हीट एंड इन टू द कूलिंग टावर दैट विल एक्सट्रैक्ट द हीट इन टू द एटमॉस्फेयर। देन आफ्टर द कूलिंग द प्राइमरी रेफ्रिजरेंट दैट इज अमोनिया, दैट लिक्विड रेफ्रिजरेंट एट हाई प्रेशर इज सेंट टू द रिजर्वायर। हेयर द बेसिक पर्पज ऑफ द रिजर्वायर दिस इंश्योर द ओनली लिक्विड रेफ्रिजरेंट विल फ्लो into the throttle valve, never vapor refrigerant will enter into the throttle valve. Here in throttle valve expansion takes place from high pressure to low pressure and after expansion we get the ammonia refrigerant, primary refrigerant at low pressure, low temperature that enters into the evaporator. So we can say here primary refrigerant flow takes place through these components. Now we will come to the secondary cycle here that completed by the binary solution. This is also known as the secondary refrigerant. In this we can see here the brine solution that enters into the chilling tank from ice cans that absorbs the heat and then that hot brine solution enters into the evaporator. Here by the primary refrigerant heat will absorb from the brine solution and then cold brine solution enters into the chilling tank. So this secondary cycle is completed in which brine solution is a working medium, is a cooling medium that is also known as the secondary refrigerant. This flow takes place from the chilling tank to the evaporator. Here we get the ice into the ice cans by absorbing the heat through the brine solution and that heat is sent to the evaporator and finally this heat will extracted into the condenser by the cooling tower. Here in this we are releasing the amount of heat from which is absorbed from the ice cans. It means in this we are using a cooling medium that is a brine solution because we know that here when we are using the medium air then we get a less amount of heat transfer. Here in this chilling tank we also use as agitator or a propeller which makes the continuous motion of the brine solution. It means in this we are transferring the heat in convection mode. It means brine solution always takes place motion inside the chilling tank and heat transfer from the ice can to the brine solution by the convection. So this brine solution absorbs a large amount of heat from the ice cans, so here cooling takes place and get ice. And so if the refrigerant absorbs a large amount of heat, then we need to extract this heat into the condenser that also need a large capacity of condenser. So we are using here water cooled condenser because we need to extract the large amount of heat from the condenser into the atmosphere. Here we can say in primary cycle, here primary refrigerant flow takes place through the compressor, condenser, throttle valve and evaporator. In evaporator here we are using a brinery solution, that is in secondary cycle. Here cold brine solution flow takes place through the cooling coil. In chilling tank here that absorbs the heat from the ice cans. After the absorbing heat from ice cans, brine solution get to the hot, and then hot brine solution enters into the evaporator where heat will absorb by the primary refrigerant, that is ammonia, and then this brine solution will cold, and then cold brine solution continuously flow through the cooling coil to the evaporator. Here the basic difference in ice plant or in any another window type AC or any vapor absorption refrigeration cycle is different here. In this we are using the cooling medium, that is a brine solution, because in this case a large amount of heat is needed to extract from the ice cans. So we are making here heat flow takes place in liquid medium and as well as in convection flow takes place, because we know that when heat transfer takes place in convection medium, then that rate of heat transfer will be high. So here we are using the brine solution, that flow takes place around the ice cans. It means in this here heat transfer takes place by the convection medium from ice can to the brine solution or cooling coil. So here rate of heat transfer will be very large compared to the conduction heat transfer here. And we are using here liquid, because we know that convection heat transfer coefficient for liquid is very high compared to the air medium. So to increase the capacity of the cooling, we are using the brine solution and making a flow of heat transfer through the liquid medium. This is the basic difference which are used in ice plant. After the formation of ice, ice can is removed from the brine solution from the chilling tank, and then ice is eliminated from the ice cans and filled fresh water into the ice cans and again replaced into the brine solution inside the chilling tank for the formation of ice. This is the final product which we get from this plant, that is ice cubes. Now we have come to the cooling tower here. The contents of cooling tower, introduction of the cooling tower, what does a cooling tower do, where cooling tower is used, different parts of cooling tower, how does it work, these topics will cover throughout this session about the cooling tower. So first, introduction of cooling tower. The cooling tower is one of the most important device in industries. For example, when the hot water comes from the heat exchanger, in HVAC we can use condenser, heating, ventilation, air conditioning. It means we use the cooling tower to cool it. The cooling tower is made up by FRP, fiber reinforced plastic. Here the second one is, what does a cooling tower do? Cooling tower are used to transfer heat from cooling water to the atmosphere, promotes efficient water usage, prevent environmental damages. So this cooling tower is used. Here is the real application of cooling tower. This is used in HVAC, heating, ventilation, air conditioning unit, power station, oil refineries, natural gas plant, petrochemical plants, because it's cost efficient to reuse water. So basically cooling tower is used. Now we have come to the working of cooling tower and basic component of cooling tower. Here in this we can see, here is the motor is used. The basic purpose of motor to run the fan. Here fan, this force the air to flow in this direction from lower to upward direction. Here air get to outlet. Here motor cap is used to cover the motor for the safety purpose. Here ladder is used to maintain the cooling tower. Here in this whole setup, here hot water enters into the nozzle head, and through the nozzles here that is spread out into water droplets. Here through the mesh, air enters from this direction. Air flow takes place in upward direction because here fans is run that forces air get to out. When air is flow takes place from bottom to top here, then that air is absorbed the heat from the hot water, and hot water is cold. Then hot water is collected into the sump tank here. Here is a makeup water. This is used to make level of water into the sump tank. Here is the overflow. When overflow takes place, then water will out through this overflow valve. And here the drain valve is used to clean the sump tank. So we can say here hot water comes and that enters through the inlet here into the cooling tower and get cooled. After the cooling of water, that water is out through the outlet and sent to the use into the plant where we want to use cooling tower, cooling water. Now we have come to the types of cooling tower. Here one is the natural draft cooling tower. In this we are not using any mechanical device for the cooling purpose of water. This is the second type of cooling tower. This is also known as the artificial cooling tower or mechanical draft cooling tower. And this is classified two types. One is forced draft and one is induced draft. When before the heat exchanger we are using the fan, this is known as the forced draft cooling tower. And when we are using after the heat exchanger of mechanical fan, that type of cooling tower is known as the induced draft cooling tower. On the basis of fluid flow direction, this is classified two types. One is counter flow and one is cross flow. Here when hot and cold fluid flow takes place in opposite direction, that is known as a counter flow. It means here we can say air is flow in upward direction and hot water is flow in downward direction. This is known as a counter flow cooling tower. Here in this we can say here hot water flow takes place horizontally and air is flow takes place from top to bottom vertical direction, and this type of cooling tower is known as the cross flow cooling tower. On the basis of fluid flow, here is the direct and indirect type of cooling tower. When open circuit is used, it means air and fluid both are mixed. That type of cooling tower is known as direct type cooling tower. When both are flow takes place through the tubes, there only heat transfer takes place through the surfaces, that is known as the indirect type. It means there fluid flow takes place into closed circuit. डायरेक्ट कॉन्टेक्ट बिटवीन कूलिंग मीडियम एंड एयर दैट इज नोन एज डायरेक्ट टाइप टॉवर. इनडायरेक्ट कॉन्टेक्ट बिटवीन कूलिंग मीडियम एंड एयर दैट इज नोन एज इनडायरेक्ट टाइप ऑफ कूलिंग टॉवर. Here we can see there are two cooling towers. This cooling towers is known as a counter flow cooling towers because here we can see both fluid direction is opposite in vertical, and this cooling tower is known as a cross flow cooling towers. Now class is over. Thank you for listening.